This episode of STTOP is all about staying cool. And I don't mean cool as in popular because, well, that's just something you can't teach. Being overly hot in the temperature sense is an incredibly uncomfortable feeling. And I mean, look at me, you know, with my fair skin and my freckles, or sun kisses, as Mama used to call them. Needless to say, I understand the need for aircon, all right? But like many pleasures in this world, there's a cost. Aircon and electric fans make up 20% of the total electricity used inside buildings around the world. And nearly 10% of all of our global electricity usage goes to air conditioning units and electric fans. During a heat wave in Beijing, 50% of the power capacity was going to air conditioning. The gases used for cooling and refrigeration are called HFCs, and their impact on global warming can be hundreds to thousands of times greater than that of carbon dioxide. So I got to thinking, we used to live without aircon. What did we do to keep cool before then, huh? I've noticed that, like, in a house, there's usually one room that's cooler than the rest. Is this dark magic? How do we spread it? Can we harness this and cool the other rooms? So I'm gonna speak to yet another person who makes me feel self-conscious about my intellectual standing in the community. Kirsten Banks is an astrophysicist and science communicator of the Wiradjuri people. So she knows about stars and stuff. But before you get to stars and stuff, you need to know about hot and cold. Hi, Kirsten. So is there credence to my theory?
Yeah, I don't think I've heard of this cold room theory before myself. Thermodynamics can be a little bit tricky to understand sometimes, because when we talk about heat in a physics sense, they mean the flow of temperature, flow of energy. So heat can flow into a room, which makes it hotter, and heat can also be extracted from a room to make it colder. It depends on which way you go, but generally it is easier to keep a room cool than it is to make it colder when it's already hot.
How would I make my home as cool as it could possibly be?
To keep a room cool, some of the best ways to do that is to, one, stop direct sunlight from getting into the room. So if you have a window, close the blinds. And if you don't have blinds, you can even hang a towel in front of the window to stop that direct sunlight coming in, especially during the hottest part of the day.
So how do you make heat escape from a room?
So a very easy way to get the heat out is to open doors, open windows that can let heat out if outside is cooler than your hot room.
Cutting out the sun, I get that. That's like, it's very obvious to me. But what about some things that aren't so obvious?
If you have incandescent light bulbs in your home, the amount of electrical energy that actually goes into those light bulbs and gets converted into light energy is only 10%. The other 90% turns into heat. So appliances like that, that are not very efficient in the energy you want to use them for, they will dissipate that extra energy as heat, and that will heat up your room, which is not good.
With air conditioners then, are they adding cold or are they taking away, because they have exhausts, so are they taking out heat?
Yeah, so it sucks out the hot and pushes in cold. Using an air conditioner will take a lot of power to cool down your room, and with that it will still produce a lot of heat, sometimes in the room, often outside the room. But we want to try and do this without using air conditioning as much as we can, because of course using air conditioners, using any sort of electrical appliance, will produce carbon dioxide and will add to the problem of climate change. So if we can find ways to effectively cool down our homes naturally using physics, then that's the way to go.
Are there things that I should be wearing on a hot day?
So on a really hot day, it's best to wear loose clothing. Let air flow through more of your body and more of your skin, make you feel cooler.
And sweating. I know it's meant to cool us down.
Pretty much, just your body will just sweat when you need to cool down. It's a natural thing that you do.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak.
My absolute pleasure.
All right, so what are we doing? First off, find the sun. It should be up. Then block out your windows when the light's coming in, and if you want a breeze when it's coming through, that's when you open the windows. Use handheld fans. I did it this time. And sweat it out, all right? You can use the hashtag #Stop2030 or #YoureSoCool.